To neighbours, howling is a nuisance, but scientists think it can reveal a lot about what our dogs are trying to tell us. Professor Ádám Miklósi is the world's leading dog communication scientist. Can I just play you some clips, just for you to be able to, if you like, act as interpreter for me? Okay, so this is Max. So what's he saying? What's going on inside his head?
Well, I mean, first of all, we're hearing a combination of two vocalizations. That's a barking and a howling combined. The barking tells probably that I'm alone. So if you would just hear this bark in isolation, you would say that this is a little bit of an angry dog. And the howling has actually the biological function to sort of collect the pack.
The gaps that occur, that you get a kind of two or three vocalizations and then he stops, and then you'll get a couple more and he stops. Is that typical of dogs in this situation who are sad and want to be reunited?
Yes, yes. So the longer the gap is, the sadder the dog would be.
Gosh, that's fascinating. So a dog that is just barking or howling constant is probably not as unhappy or sad as a dog that barks a few times and then a long gap and then barks a few times.
Yes.
There's a further dog we've discovered. He's called Oscar, and his owners have asked if we can help him.
In this case, I think it would be categorized as an exceptional type of howling. So in a normal situation, the howling is always about reuniting the pack. However, here we have an abnormal howling, which is actually quite high. So basically, this dog is saying, I am in danger, and maybe this leads the dog to that sort of very high-pitched voice.
So the key for you in Oscar's case is not just the fact that he's howling, but the frequency of the howling is so high-pitched.
Yes, and this is probably because his situation is very much stressful to him.